PCEA Kitengela Township Church School Service, hosted by
Grade 3.
Hello guys, my name is Kelsey Wanjiro and I'm going to be praying for you. Let's bow. Oh God, may you be with us, may you protect this service as we go on. COVID pandemic has been with us. May you protect all of those parents and children at home. May you protect all of us because you've been with us since like 3 weeks of education. School has been continuing and we are having fun. May you be with us, God. Cover us in the blood of Jesus. And in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Children, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Fine.
Thank you. This is the third week that you are in school. We want to thank you, God, so much because of the care, the protection that He has offered to each one of us. We have a reason to tell God thank you this far. We have seen His faithfulness upon our life. And therefore, we want to say thank you to God. My name is Grace Boro. I'm born again this morning. I love the Lord as my personal Savior. I'm delighted once again to come to you and to have the sermon together with you, the teachings of today. We continue with the same topic that we had last Sunday. We are going to continue the topic of Trinity, but we are going to see the lesson of today about the work of the Trinity. The text is in the book of John, chapter number 14, and verse 15 to 16. And our memory verse, we are going to know it after we continue with the lesson of today. But before that, children, sit up of today.
Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom.
Yes, there is freedom where there is the love of God and the Spirit of God when it is together with us. We have learned a lot about the Holy Trinity, and we have seen that Holy Trinity is God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. We are going to see each one of them, its function, how it functions, and importance of the Holy Trinity, each one by one. And therefore, before that, we are going to have a story together, and then we continue. A story of today is about two gentlemen, and one lady and a gentleman, that is Rebecca and Ephraim. They attended the convention somewhere in a village, in a certain village, and one day as they are walking along the village, they met somebody who was preaching in the street, and that person, he was preaching about the goodness of the Lord. And because Rebecca and Ephraim were not born again, they heard the message, and the message convict them very well, such that they give their life to Jesus. So they received Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, and from there the Holy Spirit guide them this far. So the Holy Spirit, the one of the work of the Holy Spirit is to guide somebody through the journey of salvation. Children, sit up of today.
Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom.
Yes. Now, our Bible study today, we are going to see how Jesus told his disciples about loving one another as the Father in heaven loved them too. So, the Holy Spirit here, we see that He guides us. The Holy Spirit guides us. The Holy Spirit comforts us when we are so down, when we have stress. The Holy Spirit comfort us. And those who love Jesus, they only keep the commandment that the Lord Jesus gave to His disciples so that they can continue with them and obey them each and every day. So what do we learn from God the Father? God the Father, His only Son, the begotten Son, that whoever believes in him will never perish, but he will have everlasting life. That is the God the Father. God the Father also, he gives us life and gives us life in abundance. So that is God the Father. Again, God the Father, he condemns our sins. So therefore, it is important for us, through God the Father, we obey his commandment and follow each and every law that God has given to us. Let's see God the Son. God the Son died for us. He died for our sin, me and you, so that we can have life. He also intercedes for us. He also forgives our sins. And God the Son rose from the dead and sits at the right hand side of God the Father. So let's see the God the Spirit. God the Spirit dwells in us, in our hearts. He leads us. He bears the fruits in our hearts. And he helps us because of our weakness. So God the Spirit, he is the guider. He is our comforter. He is our encourager all through. Let's see God the Father, the works of the God the Father. One, he is the creator. He is holy. He is almighty and he is everlasting. God the Son, he is our savior. He is our redeemer. He is a Messiah and he is Emmanuel, God with us, meaning God with us. Let's see God the Spirit. Number one, he is our helper. He is our guide and he is our counselor. When we are so stressed, God the Holy Spirit guides us in all through. What do we learn from the story of Holy Trinity, the whole of it? Children, sit up of today.
Now the Lord is the Spirit.
Yes.
And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom.
So children, what do we learn? Point number one, we learn that the Holy Trinity give us life. Can we say he give us life?
He give us life.
Number two, he proclaim our future.
He proclaim our future.
Number three, he dwells in us.
He dwells in us.
And number four, he teaches and encourages us.
He teaches and encourages us.
And finally, he testifies on our behalf.
He testifies on our behalf.
May God bless you so much because of understanding what Trinity is. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And I pray that God will enable you to understand more about him all through, so that you can be a very good children there at home, obeying your parents and doing what is right always. Together with me here, we have Teacher Kihara. Teacher Kihara will take us through the memory verse of today and the song of today, and then you will pray for us. God bless you.
Wow. Good morning, children.
Good morning to you.
This morning, I'm saved. Jesus and I, we are friends. I'm going to take you through memory verse and a song, but we are going to start with our memory verse of today, which comes from the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 14. And it says, "The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit." Children, I repeat again so that you can understand. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. That is our memory verse. Can we say it all?
2 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 14. It says, "The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen."
Now that is our memory verse. I'm going to take you through our song and I'm going to read it. So just listen so that you can sing together. I read, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, early in the morning, our song shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity. So we go together.
Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning our song shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God three persons, blessed Trinity.
Blessed
Trinity.
Now we pray. We close our eyes so that we can pray. Our dear Heavenly God, we thank you. We glorify your holy name. Thank you for taking us through that session, Jehovah. As now we go to our home, Jehovah bless us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Let us share the word of grace. May the grace.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Bye.